Dear student, present a topic called Ovoviviparity and Oviparity in insects. Introduction. Three main reproductive strategies have been described among insects: oviparity, oviparity, and ovoviparity. The vast majority of insect species are characterized by oviparity. A female of ovipara species lays eggs in a safety places, singly or in a masses, and embryogenesis occur after oviposition. During development, the embryo use reserve food materials stored during oogenesis in the oocyte cytoplasm and are surrounded by protective coverings, the vitellian membrane and the chorion. The second strategy, that is oviparity, it is relatively rare among insects. In this reproductive mode, the embryonic developments take place within the mother's body, which provides gaseous exchange and nourishment for the embryos. In some insect groups, less advanced transitional reproductive mode, the ovoviviparity has been reported. In this case, the embryos develop inside the eggs that are retained in the mother's body until they are ready to hatch. Hatching occurs just after oviposition, or the larvae hatch inside the mother's reproductive system and are later deposited or born. The later process is termed as larviposition. Although the oviparity is deceptively similar to oviparity, it does not require any nourishment of the embryos or larvae by the mother, as the unborn offspring use the reserve food materials accumulated in the egg cytoplasm. Reproduction. It is process by which offsprings or new individuals are produced are known as reproduction. Normally, insect reproduction is bisexual, is that the egg produced by the female will not develop until fertilized by the spermatozoa produced by the male. There are some species that are able to reproduce by parthenogenesis, a form of sexual reproduction in which new individuals are developed from unfertilized eggs. Some of these species alternate between sexual and asexual reproduction, while others are exclusively parthenogenesis. Types of reproduction. Mainly insect reproductions are of two types, namely, number one, asexual reproduction, and number two, sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction. It is the reproduction is the normal type of reproduction in most of the insects, which depends on the mating or copulation between the adults of opposite sexes, and the female will lay fertilized eggs which hatch and give rise to new young one. Types of sexual reproduction. According to the oviposition of eggs, sexual reproduction is of two types, namely oviparity or oviparous reproduction, oviparity or oviparous reproduction. Oviparity is the most common sexual reproduction, where the female lays fertilized eggs which hatch after oviposition. That is, most of the insects are oviparous, such as silk moth, cockroach, and grasshopper. In the great majority of an animal species, females reproduce by laying eggs that are developed and hatch in the external environment. This reproductive pattern is known as oviparity. In some major taxa, oviparity is predominant or universal. Several major invertebrate groups contain both oviparous and oviparous species, including insects, arachnids, crustaceans, etc. In some oviparous insects, externally fertilized eggs are taken into the body of one of the parents. This pattern is best viewed as a type of egg tending. It is analogous to a pattern called pseudo-oviparity in an amniotes vertebrate and can be referred by this same term. as a modification of simple oviparity. The eggs may be retained for various amounts of time within the female reproductive tract, resulting in a shortened incubation period after egg laying. In ovovivipara species, eggs are retained within the female for the entire embryonic period. Eggs hatch may occur just after oviposition, or larvae may hatch inside the female followed by larviposition. Types of oviparity. Ovoviviparity. Ovoviviparity is a zoological term that refers to animal that produces eggs but retain them inside the female's or male's body until hatching occurs, so that live offsprings are born. The egg hatching strategy of oviparity occurs in a rather wide diversity of animals, including certain insects, fishes, lizards, and snakes. However, ovoviviparity is much less common than the external development of fertilized eggs, but there are no trophic interaction between zygote and parents. Ovoviviparous insects do not provide oxygen or nourishment to their developing eggs. They merely provide a safe brooding chamber for development. Ovoviviparity is also seen in some fishes, reptiles, and amphibians around the world. There are varieties of reasons why animals might have evolved to give birth this way. This method of reproduction is also intriguing to many the people, since most of the people assume that egg layers cannot give birth to the live young ones. Ovoviviparity occurs in a variety of insect lineages, including cockroaches, caddisflies, tinned flies, and various families of flies. It is a common reproductive strategy in plant lice and scale insects. In case of ovoviviparity, the egg chorion is thick enough to prevent nutrients from passing from mother to the developing embryo. The principal requirements for such a reproductive strategy include the ability of the female to hold maturing eggs, adequate provisions for the hatching of larvae inside the female, and the ability of the female to larviposition to a substrate on which the larvae can survive. The most sophisticated maternal egg relationship in the insect are the various forms of oviparity. In ovoviviparity, in which an animal lays egg and the young ones hatches out, this method of reproduction used by many insects, reptiles, and others. Ovoviviparity is a blend of both methods and it is much more rare. Example, Anguis fragilis. In the CRs, zygotes are retained in the male's ventral marsupium. In the frog, Rhinoderma darwini, the zygotes developed in the vocal sac. In the frog, Rheobatrachus, zygotes developed in the stomach. Histotrophic oviparity. The zygote developed in the female's oviduct but provides surplus egg as a food for developing young one, termed as oophagy. Hemotrophic oviparity. Nutrients are provided by the female, often through placenta. In the frog, Gastrotheca ovifera, embryos are fed by the mother through specialized gills. Examples, lizards and mammals. Rhinotropic oviparity. It means gland-fed live birth. This is a reproductive mode of insects such as certain sets flies and cats. Rhinotropic oviparity differs from ovoviviparity in that eggs are retained in the female's body, hatch, and are nourished through the milk gland until the developed larvae are ready to pupate. The larvae are then lariposited and immediately pupate within the female insect. This is one way insects avoid predation during their most vulnerable life stage. In ovoviviparity, one or more eggs hatches internally in the female, but they are not nourished after hatching and are immediately larvae posited and continue their development outside the female body. Viviparity. Females retain fertilized egg inside their bodies and give birth to their young ones are known as oviparity. Most peoples are similar with ovipary, in which an animal gives birth to the young ones after it has developed in the uterus for a period of which can range from weeks to almost 2 years in the case of elephants. The taxonomic distribution and evolution of oviparity in insects is critically reviewed. The phenomena ranges from ovoviviparity through oviparity to pupiparity. It means the offspring deposited as pupa. Some diptera are known to be facultative oviparous, which is hypothesized to be a step towards the evolution of obligate oviparity. Obligate oviparity is found to comprise unilariparity, it means the single large larva in maternal uterus, which is evolved many times independently, the rare oligolariparity and multilariparity, it means large numbers of developing larvae in uterus, which is typical for two largest clades of oviparous diptera. Unilariparity is either lithotropic or pseudoplacentar. Oviparity has clearly evolved on many separate occasions in diptera. It recorded in 22 families, and this review identifies at least 61 independent origins of oviparity. 6 families appear to have oviparity in their ground plan. Some families have a single evolution of oviparity, others multiple evolution. Kumarese's model for the evolution of oviparity in diptera is tested against phylogenetic information, and the adaptive significance of oviparity is reviewed in detail. Possible correlations with life history parameters are analyzed critically. Morphological constraints, adaptations and exceptions are reviewed, including the provisions of an incubation place for the eggs and positioning of the eggs in uterus and maternal glands. The main morphological adaptations include greater egg size, reduction of egg respiratory filaments, thinning of chorion, modified larval respiratory system, mouthparts and instars keeping. Female morphology and behavior is particularly strongly modified for oviparity. Ovaries of the unilariparous species have a reduced number of ovaries with alternate ovulation. Plea is a made for more detailed morphological and experimental study of many of the oviparous species. Oviparity in diptera provides a fascinating example of multiple parallel evolution and fertile field for future research. This is the exceptional type of sexual reproduction in which embryonic development is completed inside the body of the female parent. Instead of laying of eggs, the eggs are hatched inside the body of the female and the young minute larvae crawl out through the genital opening. These patterns can be viewed as reproductive strategies, patterns that have advantages as well as disadvantages that affect their evolution. An advantage of oviparity, for example, embryos are protected and physiologically maintained by the pregnant female. In many oviparous insects, the mother provides nutrients to the embryo during gestation, a pattern known as metrotrophy. Oviparity and metrotrophy are the phenomenon of considerable biological interest. They have been studied from the standpoints of meteorology, physiology, endocrinology, ecology, and evolution. In oviparous species, the egg chorion is thin enough or specially modified to permit nutrients to pass from the mother to the developing embryo. Examples of this developmental strategy can be found in cockroaches, book lice, aphids, and scales, parasitic earrings of the genus ephemerus and various flies. Example, the set flies, glossina species. Oviparity and short retention of developing eggs in uterus or other specialized brood chambers are widespread in invertebrate taxa and evolved many times independently. Strategy of brood protection involves different mechanisms of providing nourishment for the developing embryos as well as the array of anatomical and morphological adjustments. Brood protection increases offspring survival but may reduce maternal fecundity. Types of oviparity. Mainly four types of oviparity are observed in different insect groups, with many of the specializations prevalent in various IR dipterans. Ovoviviparity. The phenomenon of ovoviviparity is present in the several metazoan phyla and is fairly common occurrence among the arthropoda. Insects of many species give birth to either nymph or larvae instead of laying eggs, some parthenogenetically, others with bisexual reproduction. Among these are representatives of the Ephemeroptera, Orthoptera, Hemiptera, Lepidoptera, Coleoptera, Streptoptera and Diptera. It is the method of reproduction in animals in which embryos develop inside the eggs that are retained within the mother's body until they are ready to hatch. Ovoviviparity reported for the first time in the ground beetle family Carabidae. A closed larvae and fully developed embryos are found within the expanded larval oviducts, bursa capillatrix of the putative mammophiles. A closed larvae do not appear to be active while held inside the female prior to larvification. Maximum larval numbers occur from mid-July to early September in these Arizona species, implying that larvification is timed to coincide with the summer rains. Larvification is hypothesized as a means to eliminate egg mortality due to predation by ant wasps. Ovoviviparity in mayflies has been observed in Calibetus ovipara of South America and Chloean dipteran of Europe. In North America, the production of living young seems to be a confined to the genus Calibetus. Ovoviviparous, it is a differ from oviparous reproduction in that there is a no placental connection and the unborn young ones are nourished by the egg yolk. The mother's body does provide gaseous exchange. The fully developed egg hatch immediately after being laid up just prior to ejection from the female reproductive tract. This occurs in some cockroaches, some aphids and scale insects. Adenotropic oviparity. Fertilized eggs develop inside the swollen part of the common oviduct termed the uterus. After hatching, the larvae are retained in the uterus where they feed on a highly modified accessory gland termed the milk gland. This type of oviparity has been described in the dipteran insects. Hemocoelous oviparity. Embryos and larvae develop in the hemocoelus and take nutrients directly from the hemolymph. Hemocoelous oviparity has been found in Streptosterans and dipterans from the family CEC-UGC, but they possess highly modified depressed ovaries. Pseudoplacental oviparity. Embryos and larvae develop inside the terminal ovarian follicles and are nourished by the highly active follicular epithelial cells that in earlier stages is surrounded by developing oocytes. This epithelium is thickened and termed by Hagen as the pseudoplacenta. Pseudoplacental oviparity has been described in aphids, cockroaches and both epizoic dipteran groups, the Oryxinia and Ephemerina. It is interesting to note that the placenta-like structure functions also during development of the endoparasitic wasps, aphids, earwig. Her placenta invades the tissues of the host and transfer nutrients prepared for the host offering to the endoparasitic embryo. Differences between the oviparity and viviparity. Oviparous animals. Females lay fertilized or unfertilized eggs. The development of zygote takes place outside the female's body. Females lay eggs in safe places in the environment, but the chances of survival are less. The ovoviviparous animals do not provide nutrition to their young ones through a placenta, as in the case of oviparous animals. Instead, the developing young ones inside the egg feed on the egg yolk. Example, all birds, most of the insects and reptiles. Oviparous animals. Females give birth to young ones. The development of zygote takes place inside the female's body. Females deliver young ones and the chances of survival are more. In oviparous animal, to provide nutrition to their young ones through a placenta. Provides some gas exchanges to the developing egg. Provides protection for the egg, allowing them to develop without the risk of being eaten by the other animals, example, mammals, except egg-laying animals. Advantages of oviparity. Animals can lay large clutches of eggs, ensuring that at least some of their young will survive. Advantages of oviparity. Oviparity means live birth, which, as you probably know, humans ascribe to you. There are alternatives like ovipari, which means egg birth. So, knowing that there are these two basic options, evolutionary biologists wants to know which one is better, and by that they mean more derived, which would suggest that it is selected for over time. Advantages of oviparous. Animals can only incubate a limited number of eggs at a time, typically give birth to the more than 6 young ones. Therefore, the young ones are more precious to their parents. Young ones are typically also very well developed and precocious, able to negative and hold shortly after birth, although they may still require guidance from their parents. In some ovoviviparous animals, the young ones are born in larval form and they metamorphose outside the bodies of their parents. Others are born fully formed, although they can require several weeks for months to mature to the size of their parents.